Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Shafer here. Check out the new model I just designed. It is an expanding octahedral ball. Ready, set, here goes. So for this model, you need 19 squares of paper. We need 12 squares for the 12 edge modules because an octahedron has 12 edges. And we need 6 squares for the 6 vertex modules because an octahedron has 6 vertices, in other words, 6 points. And 1 sheet for the stencil, which we'll use for the 12 edge modules. We're gonna begin with the stencils. So white side up, fold in half. Unfold and fold to the crease. And unfold. Now fold this corner up so that this edge aligns with the crease. And repeat. Unfold both those flaps and now fold the flap so that this edge aligns with the crease. And repeat. And unfold both those flaps. Now fold the bottom edge up on this point and this point, where the two creases hit the edges. So it's like that. And the stencil is done. All right, now grab one of your 12 edge squares and turn over and stick it underneath this flap. Make sure it goes all the way in. And now fold the bottom edge up and you want to align the fold with this edge. And unfold and pull it out, rotate 180 degrees and stick it back in. And fold the bottom edge up again. And put the stencil away for now and refold here and rotate, turn over and fold in half. And rotate and fold this flap up to the top. And turn over and repeat. Now fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with the top. And repeat. And turn over and repeat. Now unfold this flap. Open here, and we're going to reverse fold it. So just push this point in and pinch on the corner and flatten. So there's the reverse fold, and we have to reverse fold the other three. So here goes. Okay, So here is a shortened pig base. And now open this slot and we're going to reverse this flap. So first open it and just fold it down, making the fold right here. Just like turning the page of a book. And now close it like this. Now turn over and repeat. So open here and just push this flap in like this and close. And our first module is done. And now we have to repeat that 11 more times. And I'm gonna fast forward this part. All right, so all edge modules are complete. Now it's time to work on the vertex modules. And this one, we don't need a stencil. So the vertex models are just sunken water bomb bases. So if you know how to do that, then just do that. But I'm gonna show you how now. So let's begin white side up and fold diagonally in half. Unfold, rotate, and fold in half in this direction. Now fold this corner to the top. Turn over and repeat. Open the big pocket, put your finger inside, and push the left and right sides together and flatten. And here we have the water bomb base, and now we're going to sink the top. So rotate and fold the corner to this point. And now completely unfold and turn over. And now we're going to go around this square, pinching it. And it's good to have your finger behind to provide support. So pinch, pinch, pinch. And just travel around the square. So here we have the square of folds, and now press the middle in and pinch these two edges together. So it's like that, and pinch these two edges together. And here, and here. And now push the middle in again and make all of those folds at the same time and flatten. And here we have the sunken water bomb base. And now we have to repeat that 5 more times. And I'm gonna fast forward this part. All right, so we've completed all 12 edge modules and all 6 vertex modules. And now it's time to assemble them. So grab 4 edge modules and 1 vertex module. And we're going to attach the 4 edges onto the 4 flaps of the vertex. And 1 vertex module, and we're going to attach them. Turn the vertex module over and slide 1 flap of the vertex module into the slot here. And now we're going to insert these 2 flaps into this pocket. And we're going to use the Rob's World method. So fold this flap over the edge, both edges, like that. And now unfold and fold the rear flap over both edges. And unfold, and now open the pocket and put them in. And it should be able to slide easily. Like that. If it doesn't slide easily, then you'll have to loosen it by sliding it up just a little bit. Make sure that it slides easily. Okay, and slide it over. And now we're going to repeat. And next. I'm gonna fold it over like this. Try that. Unfold and put it in. Yeah, that seems to work a little bit better. And the fourth one. Okay, so one vertex has four edges on it. Now grab another vertex and just make sure it's not a purple one. That's what I'm gonna do anyway. It doesn't matter what color combination you use. Here goes. Okay, and now I'm going to attach a green one onto the adjacent edge. So the one next to here. And here goes. All right, so this is what it looks like so far. We have the top, the North Pole, and we have a blue on here and a green on here. I want to put a blue on the opposite side from the blue. So here goes. And a green opposite to this green. All right, so here we have the ball taking shape. We have almost all of the vertex modules in place, but one more goes down below. Putting the purple opposite to the purple. And now we're going to do the equator. And for the equator, I'm going to use the magenta modules. Okay, so the magenta equator is complete. And now I just need to attach the south pole, which is now the north pole. So we need to get some edge units. So I'm going to do orange and orange to complete the orange ring. And the other orange. Okay, so the orange ring is complete. And now just need to finish with the yellowy green ring. And now just reinsert any of the points that have fallen out and expand them out all the way. And pinch all of the flaps so that they're nice and tight and won't come out, hopefully. Okay, so there is the expanded ball intersecting octagons. And now it's time to transform it. So I'm gonna try to push the purples together. And now push the blues together. And push the greens together. So there's the closed model. All right, well, I hope you guys were able to fold this. It's a pretty difficult model and it does open in all of the directions. It's not quite as smooth as I was hoping. But if you adjust the connections, then you might be able to make it a little bit more smooth. And I find that if I jiggle it, it just kind of goes in a little bit easier. Maybe. So, all right. See you guys later.